Okay, well, we're gonna go ahead and start, because reasons. I left my Magikarp up because I think it's cute. Okay. I think we've stabilized now, so it should all be good. Yep, there's I is! I dyed my hair. It's back to the original color. Well, ish. It's the color I usually use. I went out today and I couldn't find the little stud things that I was actually looking for. Oh, and of course, I just realized that I probably left my my fabric glue in my car because I'm a derp. Although, what I ended up getting was earring backings or earrings. Because with these, with the felt, just stick them in there. Oh, these actually have loops on them. I didn't realize that. Ooh, I could get a little chain and I could go all the way around this and then get a very small silver chain and then go through these and tie them all together. And that might actually look cooler. I may have to, I can either do one of two things. I can either snap off the hoops, I could leave the hoops on, and or I could put a chain through the hoops. Because I didn't realize, because this is the closest thing I could find, and they have little hoops on them. See the hoops? Focus. Yeah, see, they got a little hoop. So what these are going to end up looking like when they're placed on the collar, my initial intent was just to, there we go, punch it in, and then you'd have like these little studs go all the way around, but there's hoop, but the hoop on that means I could put the chain on that. So I was going to just glue them on. Because I can snap them off and glue them on, or I can snap them off and put a chain on. Which actually, if I find my jewelry box, because that was kind of an idea that I was thinking about doing anyway, was doing a choker with studs and a chain. Yeah, because there's four of these here, so that would be enough to go two on the side, because what I really kind of wanted to do was have them go around, and then I was going to have a little skull off the center, because I have this little skull bead. I was going to build a neat little choker out of it, because my daughter's got one like that, where it's like a more advanced choker. It's got like studs and little things hanging off it, like more of a necklace. So, I mean, I'm going to end up doing this last because I have a few more things I'm going to pull out, but it's going to be fancy. It's going to look really cool. I just got to finish this. It's not really putting any more work on me right now. Now the most work that's going to come out of this is going to be getting the tail done and getting the back legs done, because the back legs are probably going to prove to be more complicated than anything else. To make sure that the thickness is right. The colorings are right. So if I do it like this, you can't even see because it's so dark. If I roll the felt into the felt, I'm gonna make this like, I'm gonna blow this out so it's visible. If I roll felt into felt, that'll help thicken these up a little bit. And I don't know if you noticed, I kind of eye roll everything anyway. I gotta do a little more work on it anyway, because I'm gonna Velcro it, I'm gonna have to sew it. I mean, I can glue the Velcro on, it'll be fine, but I went ahead and I got another piece of the same color of the tail felt, so I can go, I'm gonna probably go over a little bit more, just to reinforce it. But I'd rather send this out when it's like really done, than just rush it. It is true, no one's really going anywhere right now. I'm not even sure when we're going to be getting back to normal, because it was supposed to end on Tuesday, but I'm going to have to do some research and find out if Indiana is going to let us go back to work or not. I know my boss is getting angsty, and I'm kind of getting angsty. Seeing a lot more people with masks on, a lot more people scared, it seems. They're queuing at Walmart now, which is weird. I think they're only letting so many people in at a time, which again is weird. So it's a little bit fuzzier. But otherwise, yeah, I did some interesting things today. Well, not knowing when I'm going to be allowed to go back to work. I mean, my boss is one of those bosses that's like, if you guys want to come in, I'm not going to stop you. And I know he won't, but at the same time, we all have to kind of follow whatever the state's rules are. Because it's state by state here. It's not like the entire country is on lockdown. It's state by state, with the entire country giving a recommendation of what they want us to do. So it makes things a little more interesting. And Indiana went on lockdown Tuesday before last. So this week we hit our halfway point. Like halfway done with self-imposed quarantining or social distancing rules. Well, social distancing is still going to go on, but I'm not sure to what extent. And that's the big thing, is it still going to be... Because, like, JCPenney's is closed. Like, I went in and I was able to go to Joann Fabric today, because Joann Fabric sells fabric supplies so people can make masks and stuff. But, like, Penny's was closed. Because I guess they considered Penny's a non-essential business. And it's true, it's better safe than sorry, although it's more for protecting our elders, which is what it needs to be, and the kids. Because, no, for the most part, we're not necessarily in a high-risk bracket, as long as you practice social distancing, you know, you keep about 6 feet away from other people, you're actively coughing on people, you're washing your hands, you know, wiping down carts and surfaces and stuff, you're reasonably safe. It's when you have people that are actually sick and you come into contact. But then the other problem that they're finding now is they're finding out that a lot of people are asymptomatic, so they don't even know if they're sick. And that's really scary. And that's where it gets kind of terrifying. Is when you get to, you know, places where you get people that don't know that they're sick, and then they actually are sick. Let's see. I think I'm gonna put his legs back a little bit, like this. So for us, it's like trying to limit the amount of time that we're outside, and, well, at least out, like, shopping and stuff. Which can be really difficult, especially when you have a farm and you got kids and things. Like, we were able to get a few things online, which was good, but then there's other things like feed. Like, we had to go to the feed store today, because you start running low on animal food. You know, and then also paychecks only come once a week for us here. Or, well, not even, but they're like, one's bi-weekly, mine's weekly, and then it's the larger payouts that we get during the month for just the way our household's set up. And so you gotta kinda run and go get the supplies while the money's in. And that's a big stressor too. Plus, it's seasonal here. Like, it's spring. If spring's coming on here, which means seasonal allergies, and then people don't know. We've been playing this kind of, is it corona or is it a seasonal allergies roulette? Which freaks a lot of people out. tuck this little guy's back feet in so he can kind of like lay down. Like I said, my thing right now is when it's going to be safe to go back to work, and it looks like next Tuesday I'm probably going to be showing up unless I find, you know, unless there's a definitive on the state website, because we have so much disinformation. Because you got a lot of what it is, and I don't know how it is in other countries, but a lot of how it is here is there's so much just media panic. That guy doesn't look like he's on nearly thick enough. Yeah, I'm going to have to reinforce this arm. It's going to be more of like a soft sculpture. It is a soft sculpture. So there's going to be certain positions that probably aren't going to be too malleable, but it's going to be better for the sculpture because it's going to be structurally more sound. So this guy stays here. This is more structurally sound. I'm kind of worried about this hand, the way this is looking. I'm going to have to add a lot more. Because that seems to be on fairly weak. Or, you know what? No, we're going to take you off and I'm going to redo this arm a little bit so it's a little bit more sound. And that'll also mean I can change placements a little. Yeah, I think it's going to be better if we change up that placement anyway. Yeah, see, this will make it a little more... Yeah, this will give it some more structure. And this polyfelt's a lot stronger. Oh yeah, well I try. I think we all kind of try. Like I know I was talking to Kranitz last night or the other night, and I guess he said that you guys were going to try to work on your computer. So I know he was waiting for you in Discord. So I don't know if you guys have gotten to do that yet. But he's a good guy too. He likes his projects. It's good for him. He likes helping people too. That's all you can ever do is try to be your best. gonna pull this apart a little bit so I can stuff some of this felt in here. That's what this tool is for, actually. Oh, don't. Well, I'm glad that you don't feel nervous around me. I really am. And believe me, compliments are appreciated. But you can just chill here. This is. I try to make this somewhat chill stream. Listen to the awesome, chilly, peaceful musics. Okay, yeah, that's a lot more secure. Figure out. I also tonight, so I can find some white thread, and I can start pinning this closed. I mean, if I can try to do an invisible stitch, it won't matter what color thread. But well, I have floss. All right, we got one leg. Got one leg done. The other leg done. Coming along pretty well. Maybe she's coming along. The mohawk kind of hides it a little bit. So here, I'm going to just place this so you can see the ears better, so there's a little more contrast. But yeah, see, she's got her ears. I may put a little something up here because this is kind of thin. Just add some more structure up in this joint too. But I'd like to be able to let this hang a little bit looser so it's more poseable. Because currently we have kind of an up here. Some kind of good chest gripping arm. I am glad this makes you happy. And I have done my job correctly. Bills, you guys can deal with it. PayPal wants money. They want lots and lots and lots of money. I've already given them money today. They do not need any more money today. What's really a pain in the ass about it is the way PayPal credit works, and we had a really bad, we had, like, everyone was out of jobs for like 6 months last year. So yes, I'm behind. I'm trying to play catch up. Is they're like, oh, why, look, you put $75 towards your PayPal bill, and we want a lot more money than that, but you've put money towards it, so we're going to continue harassing and calling you so that you pay us even more money, even though you obviously don't have it, or you would have paid them already. My favorite animal. Monkeys. My mascot is a monkey. It is a magenta monkey, and this is going to be from Magenta Monkey Studios. But I also like, I like lots of different animals, but yeah, we're going to go with monkeys. I also like goats, because I've had goats before. And the Icelandic ships. Let's see. this is that's Maggie is the magenta monkey. I of course love my chicken too. I love my rooster. But Maggie's the channel mascot. I actually have a couple gifs of her animated that I need to incorporate into the channel at some point. I was trying to build her into a stream pet, effectively, so that users could control her with Giftbot, but I've had a lot of problems really getting it to work correctly, and what sucked is I had spent so much time on it, and I had it almost perfect the way I wanted it, and then my computer crashed horribly, and I lost everything! Match the sides. I gotta fill this in. Yeah, sure. You can do a punk goat. If you want any reference material, I think I had sent you. Here, I'm actually probably gonna send you this on Facebook just because if there's pictures, I will get in trouble. So this album says sheep, but there is a bunch of pictures of a goat in here too, because I had sheep and goats. Actually, I have a goat album. Actually, I got a bunch of goat albums. Come on, load. I sent you a link to that album on the Facebooks. Cool. Apparently, I'm also just been ticketed to... Hey, Kranitz, guess what? Our household has gotten 2 tickets, full conference passes to Gen Con. So you have absolutely zero excuse not to go. Because that means you can either borrow Matt's pass, or I can give you my pass. Or we'll figure something out. And that would be a good spot for you to go meet people. Gen Con. It is one of the largest gaming conventions in the country. It happens in Indianapolis, Indiana, which means it's very close by to where we live. And my buddy Solomon just bought 2 full conference passes, so in case it sells out or something, we're completely covered. Since there's no names attached to the badges, we can transfer them over. So it'll probably be Saturday, Sunday passes, so we can go up on the weekend. Here, I'll show you. So this is Gen Con. I'm hoping we're supposed to have a Twitch meetup already there. So people from Twitch. It starts Thursday. It was actually supposed to be the same weekend I was going to do Hackers on the Farm, but I don't think I'm doing Hackers on the Farm this year. There's just too much. Here, check this out. So as far as we know, we're still doing it. But they do, it's huge tabletop gaming of all kinds. There's some really cool panels, there's lots of interactive stuff, and then there's, of course, anime. All the animes. You know, you could always schedule yourself to come out and do that. I don't think it's terribly expensive to go. I think passes are only like $100-$120 or something. Solomon tries to go most years. I think a lot of people from the hacker community have kind of given up on DEF CON. So it looks like he's doing Gen Con this year, which is awesome because that means that Solomon's going to come visit. Which if I schedule Hackers on the Farm for like after Gen Con, so it starts, I think my birthday's on Friday this year, so that means it's going to be my birthday weekend. That means I won't have to like go crazy and cook and stuff. Yeah, I think we'll just not do Hackers on the Farm this year. If we do it, we're going to do it much later in the year with all this corona nonsense kind of dies down a bit more. Welcome in, welcome in. How's my badger doing today? I saw you were playing some WoWs earlier and then doing some arts. You know, tell me, how'd your stream go? How are you doing? I haven't seen you in a little bit. I'll wait until you get out of commercial hell, because apparently everyone has to sit through commercials now on Twitch. And then I'll ask again. There she is. That's okay. That's okay. Twitch changed it so even with the raids, you have to sit through the commercials and things, so it's alright. Yeah. No, that's understandable. That's understandable, Coffee. How are you doing? Oh, there's Fur Wizard. Hello, Fur Wizard! Welcome in, guys! I'm working on a Goth Possum today. This is a commission from Coffee Addicted Zombie, who's also in chat. I'm going to have to probably adjust the camera a little bit. I adjusted it extra bright because otherwise the black doesn't show up like at all. But what we have here is we have a gothic opossum. Isn't she cute though? She's so cute. Here, let me adjust this down a little bit so you can see the colors a little better. Yeah, see, that's the problem with the black on this camera. But yeah, she's gonna hang. So I'm finishing up doing her feet. Kranitz said he had some Velcro, so I'm gonna do the final stuff on the tail, and then we'll make it Velcro so she can actually hang. So it'll stick, and then it can be a hanging possum by the tail. And I'm almost done with this. I just got a little more, just to kind of get this situated, and some blending to do. And yeah, she's doing pretty cool. I like her anyway. Hey, Fur Wizard, how are you guys doing today? Yes, golf possum. But yeah, how are you guys doing? Like I said, you're welcome, you know, come hang out, chill. Tell me about how your week's been. I know a lot of us have been in quarantine. So what have you guys been doing and keep busy? Then again, it's really funny on Twitch, especially in creative community, is we're all so introverted that it's like, well, I've been doing the same thing that I always do. Because I don't go outside. It's like, what is this human contact you speak of? Yep, so, Fur Wizards. Cool. So, I'm glad you're making it through Friday. Yeah, you know, and like I said, you know, we just kind of chillax inside. So, you're doing WoW and Magic. I don't have WoW right now. I canceled my subscription because I wasn't finding I had enough time to play. And then, like, a week and a half later, we went into quarantine. And I'm like, I should have uninstalled it. Because I wanted really badly to go through some older content and play catch up. Mm-hmm. I think that, you know, I think a lot of us just don't want to be on this planet anymore, so, you know. It's okay. We're all making do pretty well, I think. I think everyone's gonna be fine. Just gotta, you know, get through this little bit that's going on right now. I mean, seriously, even Kranitz seemed to have been in a pretty good mood, so kind of go by that. I think we'll be fine. Oh, you and all my other crazy Trekkie friends. So, have you ever seen Trekkies or Trekkies 2? This is a serious question, because I'm going to be telling a story. Yeah, it is. It is a movie about the Star Trek fandom that came out, I don't know, like late 90s or early 2000s. And I've lived with the star from that. I actually, when I worked out in Hollywood, Gabe Corner and I roommated together. We both worked at Digital Domain. But he's like the... He co-produced the second movie or something. I don't remember. But he's like the ultimate of the Star Trek geeks. He's the biggest of Trek fans. But he's one of those, they work on a lot of the fan films and some of the shows. And No, not Galaxy Quest. Galaxy Quest was based on the Star Trek fandom. It was its own film. Do you think she's cute? So a little more work to do here, trying to strengthen up some of these limbs. I don't really like how thin this is. I wonder if something get a hold of this when I wasn't looking. It's like I've taken my eyes off this for 30 seconds, and now it doesn't feel right. This is also why I like using the polyfelt. I know a lot of people are very strict about, oh, that's not real needle felting. I'm like, you know what? With art, sometimes you just gotta use whatever techniques you can in order to make things.
Hey, honey?
Work. Yes, sweetie?
So tickets to Gen Con are procured.
Yep, I saw. Yeah. Thank you.
That means thank you.
Well, thanks, Solomon, but yeah.
How'd you know?
Because he's been talking to me about it.
Okay.
So we'll probably be trading out on the tickets.
Yep, I offered to give him money. He said, no, don't worry about it.
Yeah. Are you planning on going?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's funny perspective-wise here. Is
well,
like,
I'll see if I can buy Kranitz a ticket then. Would be best to do would be just to give him mine and then see if Matt could go. Wow, that must have been a long time ago. This has been in Indianapolis for as long as I've ever known about it. I'm streaming, so we're talking in the chat, and okay. Furwizer says that last time he went to Gen Con, it was still in Milwaukee. So, although what might work better is, I can give him my ticket, and you can take him and try to introduce him to people.
Okay.
But we can go back and forth with that, because I might be on a panel. I need to talk to a couple people.
I kind of laughed on the perspective of, like, yeah, you know, at one point I used to go to all the conferences all the time, never had money. Now I'm on the opposite side of the scale of, I have money, but I don't really go to conferences.
Yep, it happens. You would get along with Gabe if you're a huge Trek fan, Coffee. He is definitely an interesting person. I believe Kranitz also likes Star Trek. He got into those many of the specials. Actually, Kranitz writes very well his own fiction. In his own worlds. I really wish that he'd do more writing. But I just think he needs a little more encouragement to do it. He's also extremely talented. He would have been an amazing costume designer. He really knows how to put looks together. I think he missed his calling. He should have been a wardrobe assistant. Damn it, every damn time. I don't suppose my producer would like to bring me a Band-Aid. Mm-hmm, I got an owie. It doesn't even hurt, it's just an... Exactly, you can't actually show the blood on the Twitch, so you... They don't like that. You can't see it now. It's alright, these things happen. Hey, honey.
Huh?
Can you get me a Band-Aid, please?
Okay.
That's just part of needle felting. Unfortunately.
To be technical, no, I cannot.
What?
To be technical, no, I cannot.
What is that supposed to mean?
These are Band-Aids.
Okay.
I can't hand you a Kleenex.
Can you hand me an adhesive strip? Jesus. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, in all seriousness, it's already stopped. I mean, it doesn't... Yeah, it's I've already... I clot really fast.
You shouldn't
help
yourself.
I can't help it. It's one of those things that, you know, you gotta... It happens. Believe me, it's not like I want to. It's like, no, really? No, totally, I gotta... Totally get a thrill out of this, I swear. It's like, no, not really. So it's ouchies. There, now it's covered. So now when I stab myself again, you won't be able to see it. Joy. It's like needle felting artists are crazy. It's like they wear these as badges of honor.
Hey, Mom.
What?
Can we play Clue later?
Maybe.
Okay. If we have two
players,
we
Tilly, when's the last time you've done chores? No, we're not doing anything until you get some chores done, because I have to remind you, you're grounded.
For how long?
Until I say so. Go clean up the yard. I thought that was the agreement. Go clean up the yard. You can have your phone back.
We don't do a rabbit shit yesterday.
Yep, and today is a new day. That, or you can write me a 20-page essay on why stealing and lying is wrong. Grounded. Yeah, well, right now, kind of everyone is grounded, but she's particularly grounded. Like, I took her phone away, grounded. She thought it would be a really good idea to steal, like all the snacks. And I know people, and this is the, it started out with, I stole all the stacks. And then we did a little more into it, and we're like, okay, look, you know, all you had to do is ask, because we had food rationed. And so I go up there, and we call her on it, and this is the thing. If she had just said, yes, I ate the Oreos, and yes, I ate all the ice cream, that probably would have been the end of it, and she would have, and it would have been like, okay, look, go put away dishes or do chores, or, you know, we're taking your phone away until XYZ time has passed. But what she did is she denied, and lying is what got her in trouble. It wasn't the stealing of the snacks, it was stealing the $20 bill, and the lying that got her in trouble. So it started with the snacks, and then it progressed. And then after we caught her, we caught her in the act of the snacks, and she lied. It progressed a little bit further, because then she denied it. And I'd like to remind you, Kranitz lives here, Matt lives here, I live here, and Tilly lives here. There are three adults and one child in this house, respectively. And so when asked, when prompted, because Matt wanted to know where the ice creams were, and we went and I looked, and the ice creams were gone, and he hadn't had any, and I hadn't opened them yet, and Kranitz didn't have any, and I have no reason to believe Kranitz would lie to me, because he's my bestie. That leads to the teenager. And so we asked her, Tilly, where are the ice creams? Oh, I have no idea where they are, and I wouldn't have taken them. They make me sick. So her answer was not, you know, oh yeah, I opened them and I took them, sorry. Which would have still gotten in trouble because she ate all of them. All of them. But it would have gotten her in a lot less trouble if she'd been honest. And so after that's been decided and she's lying, we know she's lying, I go back downstairs and I go, you know what, screw it. I kind of want chocolate now. Where are those Oreos? And we go to go for the Oreos. And the Oreos are missing. Kranitz, do you have any Oreos? No. Matt, do you have any Oreos? Like, no. Like, Tilly, the cream in the Oreos is too rich and I get sick. Uh-huh. So then we go back and I'm like, okay, that's it. You've lied to me twice now. Give me your phone. I have this $20 here. If I give you $20, can I keep my phone? Where did you get $20 from? Because I had just taken $20 out of Matt's pants pocket the day before when I was doing the laundry and put it on top of the washer dryer. And, you know, I got it. I'm like, okay, give me your phone and the $20. Because we then, it's like, okay, well, you stole 20. You stole all the snacks. And then Kranitz starts thinking, all the other snacks are missing. Where's my Doritos? Because we had bought him a family-sized bag of Doritos right before quarantine. Because, again, this was all stuff that we were very slowly divvying out. Because you're supposed to, you gotta ration this, you know? You gotta ration. And, so anyway, we go and look and realize his Doritos are missing. So at that point, I went back upstairs. I kicked her out of the house. I go, you can get out of the house. Which is something that we've had to do before, because I need to go search her room now. And it's like, okay, you're gonna lie to me. You're gonna keep lying to me. I'm gonna find what you did. And my mom would have sent me outside at this point too. She's like 15 going on 16. She should know better. This is not like I'm 7 years old and I'm pulling some shit. This is like, no, you're old enough to know better. And we go up, and Kranitz finds hidden in the top of her closet a empty thing of Oreos and an empty thing of ice cream, and then we find hidden in her backpack a little less than half a bag of his chips. Remember, family size. This was a big bag of Doritos. So, yeah, she kind of got in trouble, and so she's been grounded. Now, this is the thing. We went through the whole thing, and I cooled off, and we let her off. We let her off. I want to be very clear about this. We let her off that night. We basically figured, okay, time's been served. You've learned your lesson. We're done. Don't do it again. And I went and replaced the Oreos, and then immediately the next day, because we told her the agreement was, you will not touch any food in the house without asking permission first. Because we are in lockdown, and because I don't want to have to keep running out to go shopping, everything is being rationed. So the next day, and I opened the Oreos and literally rationed it. I have two Oreos for me, two Oreos for Matt, two Oreos for Kranitz. She didn't get any because she ate an entire thing. And well, like I said, the worst part was the $20 bill. And so the next day, we find out she had snuck down during the night and added and ate an entire row and a half of the Oreos in the package. And we're like, okay, that's it. You're done. And so her phone's been removed since then. And she basically was told that until she finishes cleaning up the entire yard, she's not getting it back. Which reminds me, I need to unhook her internet. You know what's nice about this computer? You know what's nice about owning the internet? Do, 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 do. I'm gonna log into the modem. Gonna log into the modem. Gonna log into the modem. And ban her IP. Banning her IP. I'm banning her IP. Gonna log into the modem and banning her IP. Before I do this, just want to verify. I am 215. Well, shoot. Why am I not showing up on this? We have DHCP. Well, I may need to update this because it's not updating the way it's supposed to be updating, so I can't see everything. And the problem with me not being able to see everything, because one of these on here, what the thing is, I can see all the MAC addresses, and those are so I can just do ip/all, get my MAC address, and then just match it up real quick. Maybe not. Well, the easiest way of doing it is actually really fast and really dirty. And this is what I do. We have a in our house, I actually have a patch panel. So patch panels when you're fancy, is basically like directly unplugging it, but because she's patched through it upstairs, I'm gonna give her a couple minutes, that YouTube video is gonna end. Here she comes, while the internet's out. Because you need to go do some yard work.
I did yard work yesterday, and the day before, and the day before that.
Yeah, and you're still grounded.
Just because I'm grounded doesn't mean I have to do yard work.
How do you expect to get ungrounded?
I can do laundry.
Laundry is something that you have to do anyway. That doesn't count. Laundry and dishes are your regular chores.
I already freaking ripped on sticks yesterday.
You're not done. Continue, please.
I'll do laundry.
Yeah, but laundry doesn't count.
What about dishes?
Dishes and laundry don't directly count towards your grounding. That's stuff you're supposed to be doing anyway. It's because I know she's already finished her homework. She's just screwing around up there.
I was doing my homework in YouTube. That's what you said.
Tilly. The YouTubes are the problem.
What's the problem with that?
Because that's giving you something that's fun and you're grounded.
It's just watching people do stuff that I can't. If anything, it makes me more depressed.
she could wash down the cabinets. Hey, I got other suggestions from stream. Would you like to wipe down all the surfaces in the kitchen? She's gonna be so mad. She's supposed to be cleaning her room. That's the thing, is the whole cleaning thing. See, now she's mad. Yeah, my mom made us dust. That was one of our punishments that we'd have to kind of work through. It was, we literally cleaned the house. That was the thing, is you'd have to, like... Am I doing this on the right side, or did I just screw this up? I mean, hold on a second, I need to flip this. I should need to go the other way.
What'd you say I was changing?
I said, alternately, you can wipe down all the surfaces in the kitchen.
Will I give you my internet back?
When you're done cleaning the kitchen.
You said clean the surfaces, not the kitchen.
Yes, wiping down all the surfaces in the kitchen.
Countertops.
And the cabinets. And the drawers. And the floor. And the table. And the microwave. And like all the things. And the,
no.
And the refrigerator. And the stove.
No.
Okay. I can always just block YouTube. That's really not that hard either.
Then just block YouTube.
End quote of. Tilly, do some chores, please. She literally has been sitting there watching YouTube like all day. Yeah. I was the oldest one, so I remember all these things. That doesn't count.
You said do chores. I'm doing chores.
Tilly, I've also told you 4 times. Laundry and dishes are your regular chores, and therefore they don't count. You were told what you had to do. Wipe down all the surfaces in the kitchen.
I don't fucking feel good right now.
That's been your excuse for 2 weeks.
You
I'm sorry. It's no longer an excuse. Then you can go outside and get some fresh air and clean the yard.
I doubt that'll help.
Well, you should go do it. Well, her dishes and laundry are everyday chores. That's not, like I said, that doesn't count towards grounding because that's stuff she's supposed to be doing anyway.
I'm not grounded from my computer.
Yes, you are.
You said I was grounded from my phone.
Tilly, the computer is currently unhooked from the internet. You're currently grounded. You had enough time today to finish your homework because you're supposed to finish your homework by 2 p.m. That's what the rules are in school, too. You didn't finish your stuff by 2.
That the mastery tests take forever, and I'm going through the tutorials, which take at least 30 minutes to finish.
Yes, but it's almost 5 o'clock now, and you've had all day to do it. So now it's time to do chores. Will you stop arguing with me? I'm currently streaming. I do not want to hear from you again. You were told what you had to do. Wipe down all the surfaces or go outside and continue to do in the yard.
You made this mess. I'm not cleaning it. Yard is also your mess coming from here.
And I really wanted to just beat the crap out of her, but I'm being nice. Because if it was my mom, oh my god, I would have gotten the belt so many times. Oh, yep, she did. Because she's a brat. That's what happens when you don't have anyone stable raising you, and it makes it just that much more difficult. Okay, she'll calm down in a bit. Get some more yard work done. It's okay. When she's older, she'll appreciate that at least somebody had the gumption to stand up to her and try to put her straight. It might take a while, though. And even her sister had said, you know, she's acting like a spoiled brat and she's getting away with murder. Thank you. about that. She's pretty good at by pushing my buttons. A lot of what I just did right now is stuff that Kranitz taught me. He just said, don't give into it. He said, don't lose your temper, because he'd seen me when she's gotten me hot. He's like, just keep repeating what you told her. You know, that's what the thing is. He goes, no negotiations. That's the big thing, is she'll try to negotiate her way out of it. That's what she was doing before, where she was twisting what I told her. And said, well, you said this. Like, no, that's not what I said. I said this, and that's what it is. And this has been the thing from the beginning, when the yard is clean. Oh yeah, she thinks she's being smart, but she's just being bratty. But the problem is that she was in so many situations before she came here that unfortunately she's been trained how to be a little lawyer. So I mean, if she wanted to go into law, or she wanted to go into social engineering or any kind of pen testing, she'd probably be really good at it. But that's what happens when they get bounced around so much. As they start, you know, that's very unfortunately typical. There's a Rules for Unruly Children book that's out there that actually is what we were trying to use with her as much as possible. Because she is very difficult. Yeah, she's only 2 years off 18. is why, unfortunately, these are hard lessons that she needs to learn now before she's released to the wild. And yet, and like I said, the what got her in trouble was repeatedly lying and repeatedly stealing. And that's not stuff that is tolerated here. What's up, Kranitz? Yeah, it's almost 5. We still got stuff we need to be doing. Okay, well, you know, the lemon bars are done, and I'm just about finished with this possum. Do you have, just wondering, do you have those little Velcro things? Because I'm pretty close to where I can be done with this. I just need those little Velcro bits for the tail, and I need to do some sewing. Because I think these feet are now attached. So now we got 4 little feet. So the only real things left then are finding a very small chain for these little earrings, placing these, getting a little bit of glue underneath them, and building that little necklace. Because these are just gonna... And then I just need to put a little dab of glue underneath it once it's together. So there's gonna be one there. What did I just ask you? I need a necklace, like a piece of chain. I need, oh, Velcro. You said you had Velcro. So there, she's got little studs on her collar.
I just broke up a bunch of sticks and put them in the burn pile. You know that giant pile of sticks that was in the yard?
Uh-huh.
I've almost got that done.
Well, why don't you finish it up then?
Because I did half of it yesterday, and I did most of it today, what it was left anyway.
Well, then finish the rest of it, and you'd call it done.
There's some big sticks that I can't break. That's what I meant.
Okay, if they're too big to break, you can either drag them to the burn pile, or you can ask
they're
for someone...
They're too long to put in the burn pile, and too big to break.
Well,
I need Kranitz to use the dinghy on them again, like we did last time.
There's branch snippers...
I can't use branch snippers. I'm like a twig. I can't do that.
Really?
Use your weight.
Thank you.
Lights us back, please.
Okay. Okay, so let's see here.
Yeah, I did what I could today.
Okay.
I'm starting to feel itchy.
Probably have to sew this on. In a minute, I'm not quite done with stream yet. Once that's sewn on, that should hold it, actually. Yeah, she's good as once you put your foot down, she's fine. But she needs to have that foot.
Big dog, what are you doing? What you looking for?
I think it's with most kids, is they need to have the reminder. Give me a moment.
What are lemon bars?
Not for you.
I don't know what they are.
You know, it's a little pink, but it should work. Okay, cool. I'm gonna BRB. Okay, back. The lemon bars.
Goddamn delicious, thank you.
Good. I would like some.
How are the possums? The
possum's just about finished, actually.
Awesome.
I'm gonna try my best to do an invisible stitch here. I made these lemon bars earlier and I've been dying to try them. I don't know how they came out. Oh, they came out pretty good. That's not your fault, Chris.
It's airtight, and airtight bags and all that.
Yeah, I know, I know. It's okay.
Freezing and putting in the fridge kind of messes with it.
Hmm. I'm going to need thinner needles here, so I guess we're just going to have to kind of skip that and then go back with thinner needles to try to pierce this. I think I got the right idea. But I'm still gonna need thinner needles. Alright, so I can pre-poke those holes. But I'm still gonna need a thinner needle. Or stronger glue. I could just use the stronger glue. What? Oh, I know why they had to do this, though. I know why they had to do this. It's because they had, like, a more than one person in Kentucky was told, you need to self-quarantine, please go home and stay in your house for the next 2 weeks. Outright tell them no, and then insist on keep going out into the public and, like, actively infecting other people. So, I do understand why Kentucky had to do this. And this really came down to people simply being really stupid. Because I understand there's civil disobedience, but this was just civil disobedience for the sake of being civilly disobedient. There was really no... They were endangering other people, and so that it is a criminal act to endanger others. And unfortunately, it was... Well, the problem was they were being willfully stupid. And that's in where we start having issues, is when you have people that are go out of their way to do things that are absolutely stupid. They endanger their own freedom, they endanger other people's freedom, and then we end up with overreaches that like this that occur. these needles have a sharp end. It says right on there. issues because it's got so much goop on it. To sew this on anyway. This is also going to be cleaned. Yeah, it's like super sticky being run through all that. Do you have very teeny tiny needle nose pliers, Kranitz? Okay, I'm gonna call this for the night and then try to find a very small, teeny tiny pair of pliers. Because I'm gonna need a very small, teeny tiny pair of pliers in order to finish this, I think. Maybe not. Well, I'm still gonna need something to reclose these. Thank you.
Jess, could you put some towels in the washer from your room?
Yeah, I'm just about done here anyway. I just need to start gluing this down. What do you think of this choker, Kranitz?
Huh?
What do you think of this choker? It's going to have studs.
Looks nice.
And a chain. I need to find a very small plier, though. Gonna have the skull on the front. One more loop back, but I'm gonna need a very small pair of pliers to get that done correctly. Okay, I think I'm good for now. So we're gonna go ahead.